This tutorial is brought to you by PhotoshopTalent.com. Hey there, and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from IceFlow Studios. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing a method of making eyes really stand out. Now, in front of us, the eyes in this image are a little bit dull, they're not too bright, and they're not that saturated. And we're going to be dealing with all of these issues in this tutorial. Now, this method does work with both blue and brown eyes, but it's a little bit more difficult with brown eyes. So I may be covering that in a future tutorial. So we're going to begin, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make the selection of the eye. Now, it doesn't matter how you make your selection. I'm going to be using my pen tool, making sure paths is checked off. And I'm going to very quickly make my selection. Now, when you're dealing with anything in the eye area, you want a very soft selection. So we're going to feather the radius of 3. If you're using your lasso tool, go up to the top and click on Select, Modify, and then Feather. And you can feather it from there. So once we have our selection made, we're going to head into our Curves dialog box. So we're going to go to Image, Adjustments, Curves. And here's our Curves dialog box. And what we're going to do, we're going to start off by brightening up the selection. So we're going to drag this line up a little bit, which will brighten it up. And we're going to click on the blue channel and drag this up as well, just a little bit. So if we click OK and we view our before and after, there's our before and after. It's a little bit more blue and a little bit more bright, but it's not that great yet. This is what we're going to do. We're going to use the burn and dodge tool to really give it some depth. So we're going to head over to the side and click on our dodge tool. At the top, set a pretty small brush, around 20 pixels, obviously depends on your eye size, and make sure to set hardness around the midpoint. We're going to make sure range is set to highlights and exposure is set to pretty low. We're going to zoom in here. So what we're going to do right outside the pupil area, we're going to drag out like this. And you'll notice that it does get a little bit brighter. So we can run one or two passes around there, like so. And once we have that, we're going to grab our burn tool, and we're just going to very simply drag out on the outline just to give it a little bit of depth, just like so. And make sure you're somewhat accurate, a little bit more accurate than I am. And then if you want, you can one more time use the dodge tool, like so. Now my suggestion is to create a new pupil. So we're going to do that right now. We're going to create a new layer, like so. We're going to grab our elliptical marquee tool, and holding down shift, we're going to drag out the size of approximately the pupil, just like so. And make sure to feather. So we're going to go to select, modify, feather, and feather it. I'm going to put it at 5 and click OK. Once that's done, as long as your background color is set to black, hold down your command or control key and press delete. And we now have our new pupil, but we're missing the highlight. So we're going to create another new layer, like so, making sure our foreground color is set to white. Grab our brush tool right here. Make sure mode is set to normal. And we're just going to click. Oh, it's a little bit too. Click. There we go. And if we zoom out, we notice that the eye is a lot more effective. So if we look at our before and our after, the eye is definitely a lot nicer. It stands out a lot more. And there's a lot you can do to it. If you grab the background layer once again, we can use the sponge tool to saturate the eye just a little bit. And once again, we have our before and we have our after. So we can use this method on blue, brown, green eyes, gray eyes, whatever you want. Obviously, you would do it to both eyes because now it looks a little bit ridiculous, but you can clearly see the difference. The blue eye and the green-ish dull eye over there. So it's definitely a very, very effective method of making eyes stand out. There's so much you can do with it. You can make it a little bit less bright. You can make it even more brighter. It's up to you how you want to approach it. So if you're on YouTube, rate this video, comment the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also buy a high quality version of this tutorial. Check the description in the YouTube sidebar. And until next time, this is Howard from Ice Flow Studios. Take care.